Welcome back. We have a system of linear ODEs. There is no constant term on the right-hand sides of these ODEs. So this is a system of homogeneous equations. We can write this system of ODEs using matrix notations. The dependent variables and their derivatives form two column vectors. And a square matrix is formed by the parameters of the equations. This matrix, this square matrix, is called the coefficient matrix. The vector on the right hand side is the position vector of the system, as it gives the position of the system on the phase plane. Near the end of this video, we will discuss position vectors in details. Usually, we write this in a short form, x dot equal to ax. I have written both x dot and ax in bold because both are vectors. Sometimes we may put a small arrow or a hat over the symbol to represent a vector. A is a matrix. It is also in bold. So we have a linear homogeneous system of ODEs. And we have two problems. First, find the steady state. And second, analyze the stability of this steady state. First, the steady state. At steady state, all the derivatives must be zero. So, x dot must be equal to zero. Therefore, ax is also zero. If the determinant of a is zero, then we have an infinite number of solutions. But that doesn't help. When the determinant of a is not equal to zero, we have a unique solution. That is, x equal to 0. This solution is called the trivial solution. Take a break. Find the steady state for this system of ODEs. I'm sure you know that the answer is trivial. Back to our system of ODEs. Now, we will address the second question, stability analysis. For that, we will derive the generic solution for a linear homogeneous system of ODEs. We have a theorem that says that a solution of a linear homogeneous system of ODEs is e to the power lambda t into v, where lambda is an eigenvalue of the coefficient matrix and v is the corresponding eigenvector. It is easy to prove this theorem. Remember that a matrix can have more than one distinct eigenvalue. For example, for a two-dimensional system, the coefficient matrix can have two eigenvalues. Therefore, there can be two solutions of the form x equal to e to the power lambda t into v. If a system has n linearly independent solutions, x1, x2, x3 and so on up to xn, then it can be shown that the generalized solution for the system of ODEs is x equal to c1 x1 plus c2 into x2 plus up to cn into xn. Here c1, c2, cn are constants that we have to calculate for some given information. The proof of this theorem is easy. I will leave that to you. We will take an example to understand this theorem and also calculate the constants. We have a linear homogeneous system of ODEs. The determinant of the coefficient matrix A is minus 3. As det A is not equal to 0, this system has only one steady state at 0, 0. The coefficient matrix of this system has two distinct eigenvalues. Lambda 1 is equal to 3 and the corresponding eigenvector v1 is equal to 1, 1. So, one solution of this system is x1 equal to e to the power 3t. Remember, lambda 1 is 3. So x1 equal to e to the power 3t into the 1, 1 vector. The other eigenvalue is minus 1 and the corresponding eigenvector is minus 1, 1. Therefore, the second solution of our system is x2 equal to e to the power minus 1t, that means it is e to the power minus t into minus 1, 1 vector. Now, I can combine these two solutions to get the generalized solution for this system of ODEs. The generalized solution is equal to C1 into the first solution obtained from the first eigenvalue lambda 1 and C2 into the second solution. We have to calculate the constants C1 and C2 from some given information. Usually that given information is the initial condition. Suppose at t equal to 0, x is 2 and y is 1. In the generalized solution, replace t with 0 and this is equal to the vector 2, 1, the initial position of the system. Though written using vectors, this equation is actually a set of two simultaneous equations and we have two unknown C1 and C2. Solve this equation to get the value of C1 and C2. Now, we can write the generalized solution of our system of ODEs for this given initial condition. Note that we have the position vector on the left hand side of this equation and time is only on the right hand side. So, this generalized solution represents the time evolution of the system. Let's explore the geometric meaning of this generalized solution. Geometric understanding is vital to understand the dynamics of the system and to decipher the stability of the steady state. Remember, we use phase plane analysis to visualize the time evolution of a system of ODEs. So, we draw the phase plane with x in the horizontal axis and y in the vertical axis. The blue point represents the initial position of the system. With time, the system will move on this plane following a trajectory. The generalized solution for that particular initial condition gives this specific trajectory. Let's get back to our system of ODEs. I have drawn the eigenvectors v1 and v2. In the generalized solution, we are multiplying these vectors with some scalar terms. For t equal to 0, v1 is multiplied by 1.5 into e to the power 0. E to the power 0 is equal to 1, so I can say v1 is multiplied by 1.5. This multiplication creates a new vector, u1. As 1.5 is positive and greater than 1, u1 is nothing but an elongated form of v1 along its span. Similarly, v2 is multiplied by minus 0.5. That creates another vector, say u2. We have multiplied v2 by a negative number and that number is smaller than 1. So, u2 is on the span of v2 but it points in the opposite direction. Also, it is shorter in length. The position vector x is a resultant of u1 and u2. We got u1 and u2 by setting t equal to 0. That means this position vector x points to the initial position of the system, x equal to 2 and y equal to 1. That is obvious as we calculated C1 and C2 for this particular initial condition. Now imagine the clock has ticked and the system has evolved from this particular initial position. Let's take t equal to 0.1. In the generalized solution, replace time by 0.1. That gives the position vector at t equal to 0.1. Again, the position vector x is the resultant of two vectors u1 and u2. This new position vector is shown in yellow and it points to x equal to 2.48 and y equal to 1.58. So, that is the position of the system at t equal to 0.1. I have calculated the position vectors for a large number of different values of t and then plotted the points these vectors point to. That gives me that red curve on the fetch plane. This is the trajectory of the system for the initial condition x equal to 2, y equal to 1 when time was 0. Note an important point here. The first eigenvalue lambda 1 is positive. Therefore, as t increases, 1.5 into e to the power 3t increases exponentially. That means u1 will keep growing in length along the span of v1. But the second eigenvalue is minus 1, negative. As t increases, 0.5 into e to the power minus t gets exponentially smaller. Therefore, with time, u2 will decrease exponentially along the span of v2. So, with time, u1 is taking the system away from 0,0, the steady state, and u2 is dragging the system towards that steady state. Earlier, we learned to draw the phase portrait of a system of ODEs by drawing vectors or arrows on the phase plane. Each arrow represents dy dx at that particular point. I have shown the phase portrait of this system of ODEs. Each arrow represents the direction of time evolution of the system. The trajectory given by the generalized solution overlaps nicely with this phase portrait. Now let's jot down the key points of this video. We can represent a linear homogeneous system of ODEs using matrix and vectors. The generalized form is x dot equal to A into x. A is the coefficient matrix and x is the position vector. Here come two critical points of this video. For a homogeneous linear system of ODEs, if the determinant of the coefficient matrix is not equal to 0, then the steady state is unique and is at 0,0. A solution for a homogeneous linear system of ODEs is x equal to e to the power lambda 1 t into v1, where lambda 1 is an eigenvalue of the coefficient matrix and v1 is the corresponding eigenvector. If we have n linearly independent solutions, then the general solution is x equal to c1 into the first solution plus c2 into the second solution and so on up to cn into the nth solution. We calculate the constant term c1, c2 and so on up to cn from the initial condition. This generalized solution for a given initial condition gives us the specific time trajectory of the system. You must have noticed that the sign of the eigenvalues are playing a crucial role. They tell us a lot about the stability of the steady state and the trajectories around it. We will discuss those in the next video. Here, I leave you with a problem to solve. Have fun!